The mainstream media is shilling for China despite the fact that they may have doomed us all and this virus is probably far, far worse than we could have possibly imagined. Now, what amazes me about this is the mainstream, and that's been befuddling to me since the very beginning of this outbreak. Time and time again, we've been told, it's okay, it's not that bad, it's a small issue. And yet, well, we've seen more and more evidence that it's actually a pandemic. It's spreading. It's very bad. Now, anyone who believes China's official numbers is a fool. China is run by the Communist Party. It's very corrupt, they control information, and they always downplay and give false reports because they don't want to look bad. They don't want to look incompetent for what could be one of the greatest virus disasters of our lifetime. Even the World Health Organization has said things like, oh, we're not saying this is a global emergency because it broke out in China. No, sir, we're not talking about China. We don't, please, they donate so much of our money. They bribe them, basically. And that's the thing. A lot of these media, mainstream media, a lot of it is funded in part by China. So if China's saying, oh, downplay it, you better downplay it. Oh, if you say anything bad about China, we're going to take your funding. They defend them. Look at this person on Twitter. Tedros Adhanom says, I can't say his full name. It's time for facts, not fear. We appreciate at Google, Facebook, Tencent Global. Tencent is a Chinese company that, let's just say there's no truth coming out of that company. It's run by China. They control information. They censor the internet. China doesn't even have Wikipedia. And Wikipedia itself is a terrible source. At TikTok and at Twitter's efforts to combat misinformation and rumors on hashtag 2019 and coronavirus and direct users to reliable sources, we ask all digital companies to step up and help the world beat this outbreak. Okay, so many days ago, I made videos about the coronavirus based on reports from China, from within China, doctors, concerned citizens, footage of people sick, footage showing the state of hospitals, footage showing that the outbreak was obviously far, far, far greater than China was saying, and then the mainstream media was saying. And now you finally have the media admitting, oh, it might be worse than we know. But before we jump into this story, and it is quite absurd, a quick word from this week's sponsor.
Zuck the cuck drinks water like a duck, but he also drinks your data. So tell him and Google to shove your data up their schwing-schwangs by downloading the Brave browser. It's free, blocks online advertising, and protects your privacy and data from evil tech companies. You only see ads if you want to see them, and you get cryptocurrency for your attention. Don't let Zuck use you to make a buck. Download Brave by clicking on the link down below.
So we're back. Look at this. At WHO, and WHO's the World Health Organization, continues to have confidence in China's capacity to control the outbreak. We've seen many more hashtag 2019N coronavirus cases outside of China by now, and probably deaths, if it were not for the government's efforts and progress they've made to protect their own people and the world. What a joke! Imagine shilling for China this hard. Now you have all these Chinese shills saying, oh, well, it's not bad. China's amazing. We don't want to insult China, blah, 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 blah. But this is not the case.
Please disperse. Nothing to see here.
Here on the New York Times, because I don't want the mainstream to say, oh, these people are just using sources that don't matter. Here in the New York Times, as coronavirus explodes in China, the countries can struggle to control its spread. Now, the reason that coronachan and coronavirus are so bad is pretty simple. It's highly contagious. Okay, you know the reports I've seen say that coronavirus can, not only is its incubation up to 2 weeks, meaning you can have the coronavirus, you could be infected, and for 2 whole weeks, you have no idea whatsoever. I've also read reports that it can spread without symptoms. In other words, during the incubation period of 2 weeks, you can spread the virus. I've also read reports that it exhibits viral shedding, which means that you can recover from the coronavirus and still spread the virus for days, maybe even a week. It can spread through the eyes. This coronavirus is highly, highly contagious. Now, I don't care what the death rate is. The fatality rate is probably far worse than we know as well. because in China, they were only able to, like, test 300 people a day, and they're out of kits. Here we look, someone from China, trying to tell people the truth. Chen Qiushi says, Wuhan is short of test kits, beds. The outbreak is serious. Now, let me ask you this. If doctors in China are estimating that 50,000 or tens of thousands at bare minimum of people are infected in China, I mean, do you really quarantine 15 cities and millions of people if the outbreak isn't horrible? I don't think so.
大家好，我是陈秋实，现在是1月30号中午11点多，经历了这么多事儿，现在是我到武汉的第6天。我的名字已经彻底成为敏感词，只要带陈秋实三个字儿，带CQS，带我这张脸，在微信上都传播不了。已经有很多人跟我说，我在武汉的视频，只要通过微信传播，连号都会封掉，因为最近在中国微信上的谣言确实很多。
Okay, so there's case in point number one. Whistleblowers who talk about the coronavirus were arrested a month ago in China. People talking about it now are being blacklisted and blocked. This man probably is risking his entire life making these videos and talking about what's going on in Wuhan.
再说一个普通老百姓凭啥就非分清SARS和冠状病毒，就像现在武汉警方连他妈一句道歉都没有，就说你们情节轻微，你们把那东西说成SARS，我不懂那个科学名词应该怎么解。 有人举个例子说，有人说，哎，这山上有东北虎，大家别上山。然后有个领导说，没有，这山上没有老虎，结果他们咬死一堆。最后检查出来，哦，这山上不是东北虎，这山上是华南虎。你们说错了，你们情节轻微，你们把华南虎说成东北虎了。Now,
if Wuhan was really under control, if it was really not a big deal, as everyone keeps trying to downplay it and sympathize with China, why would this be the case? Why would they need to censor someone talking about it? This poor man, like, it's so bad in China, he's probably gonna get sick. And what can the mainstream media do? As coronavirus spreads, so does anti-Chinese sentiment. Coronavirus panic is not an excuse to spread racist memes. All you have is the mainstream, literally defending China. Is that bat? There's a picture of bat meat, a bat dish in this. They want us to pretend, I gotta block that out, because it's just disgusting. They want us to pretend like, China's not at fault, they didn't spread SARS, they didn't spread coronavirus. It's not all their fault, they possibly doomed us all. Coronavirus has put the world on high alert, but the spread of the virus has been matched by the spread of racism and misinformation. Really now. So they're trying to claim that people who say, wow, maybe you shouldn't eat koala meat, which, has been shown that they do eat everything under the sun in China. Exotic meats, bat meat, all sorts of meat. This is proven. Like, you can see pictures of China, the stuff in their markets. A lot of it's unregulated, and I'm pretty sure some of it's illegal. First observed in China, the deadly virus has killed 213 people and infected nearly 10,000. Now, I don't believe those numbers. I believe it is far, far worse than that. I believe it's huge. I believe there's probably tens of thousands of people infected, but they don't want to admit it. It's been confirmed in 16 other countries. Now, let me ask you this. If it was only 10,000 people infected, and if truly only 200 people died, how could it be everywhere? How could China be quarantining all of its cities, shutting down the movie theaters, banning travel? Well, that's not even entirely true. Travel from China and to China is not completely banned, which is foolish. Like I said, it's highly contagious, it spreads, and this is all because China has no health standards, okay? Like, a lot of the markets would never meet U.S. health standards or Western health standards. There are no standards. It's corrupt. People cut corners in China. There's so much about China that's wrong, and most of it is tied to communism. It has nothing to do with the fact that they're, you know, from China. A criticism of China is really criticism of communism and all the evils and all the problems it causes. As a panic has spread, warnings to avoid Asians in Asian-populated areas have gone viral. Many of them are blaming the coronavirus outbreak on Chinese people eating bats. There's really no bad thing humans can't make worse. If they hadn't eaten bats, maybe there wouldn't be a virus. There's evidence that this came from bats. That is almost certain. There's evidence that it came from people eating bats. That is, well, it's likely. There's also evidence that this may be a bioweapon. Think about it. If you were going to design a bioweapon, what would you want? You would want a long incubation period. you would want it to be able to, that way, if people have it, they don't know, which increases their odds of flying around and infecting other people. Furthermore, you'd want it to be infectious during incubation period, to which it is. You'd want it to be able to spread through the eyes, which it is. You'd want it to be airborne, which it is. You'd want it to be deadly. And as far as I can tell, it's 10 to 20 times more deadly than the flu. People are like, well, it's killed less people, so it can't be that deadly. This is the early stage, the calm before the storm. 2-week incubation period. What's going to happen in the next 2 weeks? You know, 2020 started off bad. Let's just put it that way. We got like one good meme. A bunch of bad things are happening. It's kind of a nightmare. There are memes about this saying, oh, it's just January. We almost had World War III. We had this coronavirus. Kobe is gone. Wow. So they're literally apologizing for the fact that China, I have so much criticism of China, and I have so much criticism of Chinese culture and communism. The way they eat is not healthy. And I mean that literally, like it is literally not healthy. In China, they believe that the fresher something is, the more nutritious it is. This is false. In reality, something that's well cooked will be more nutritious because it's easier to digest and you can get more nutrition out of it. Something that's cooked will actually be more nutritious. This is a fact. It's a myth that eating fresh vegetables, for example, is healthier. It's not. Plants are hard to digest. Vegetables are hard to digest. Cooking it makes it more nutritious. Some people in China do eat bats. However, the animals are also consumed by people all over the world, including Africa, Asia, Oceania, and even the Americas. And? That doesn't make it better. That doesn't make it right. That doesn't make it safe. It's simply unhealthy. It is also true that bats and other animals can carry coronaviruses, though according to the CDC, they barely spread to people. Yeah, that's the thing. As was the case with the MERS and SARS outbreaks, but you know what? They are. Bats carry 60 viruses that can spread to humans. 60. They're not something you should eat. You see, bats are very resistant to viruses themselves, but people who catch viruses from them are not. We're not bats. We can't resist all those viruses. They can, which is why they fly around with so many of them. Don't eat bats. I don't think it's controversial to say. I don't think it's... Like, there's literally nothing to do with where you're from. Bats carry a lot of diseases. Probably shouldn't eat them. Beef, pork, and chicken can also transmit disease. Most famously, mad cow, swine flu, and salmonella. Yet no one is vilified for having previously eaten pork during the 29 swine flu pandemic. This is such a disingenuous argument. I think it's a lie. The notion that eating a bat is inherently barbaric, disgusting, or immoral is based entirely on food practices that have been normalized in predominantly Western society. The coronavirus panic has provided an opportunity for blah blah blah. Okay, I'm done. Yeah, no, it's wrong. Don't eat bats. Yeah, this is all they can talk about. This is all they can shill for China and apologize for China and talk about this. I'm going to leave this off with this article from 2013. Bats host more than 60 human-infecting viruses. When it comes to carrying viruses that can jump to other species, so-called zoonotic viruses, bats may be in a class of their own. The flying mammals are reservoirs for more than 60 viruses that can infect humans. They host more viruses per species than even rodents do, new research shows. Saying that you shouldn't eat bats and that China is wrong for eating bats is not it's not an argument. It's not a question. Bats are highly contagious. Do not eat bats. Do not eat bats. And the media shilling for China, like, are you delusional? Wake up. Just wake up. That's merely the obvious. Well, that's all for now, folks. What do you think about this story? What do you think about coronachan? And what do you think about all the media apologizing for China, basically sucking up to China and saying, oh, well, it's not that bad. We believe in China, blah, blah, blah. Oh, people are just being mean. People are just being xenophobic. Really? Is saying that you shouldn't eat highly contagious and exotic meats, fresh, mind you, many of the time, maybe you shouldn't do that. No, it's not even a question. Bats carry so many viruses that you shouldn't eat them. It's a hazard. It's that simple. But be sure to let me know what you think. Now, as always, if you want to support my content, you can do so on Patreon or Subscribestar. There is a joining bonus if you're interested in that sort of thing. Details on my pages. Links down below in the description. You can also donate via Bitcoin, and sharing the video honestly, none of the media is going to tell you the truth. Maybe they'll tell you like weeks after the fact when it's too late. But I'm just showing you some patterns. I'm analyzing. I'm giving you my logical conclusions and analysis. Maybe that's valuable, maybe it's not. If you think it's valuable, share the video. As always, thanks for watching. This has been Mr. Obvious, and I'll see you all next time.